If you have a family that loves you, a few good friends, food on your table, and a roof over your head, you are richer than you think. Good morning, students. Welcome to SST, So Simple Tutorial. In the previous lecture, we saw what is liberalism, what does it represent socially, politically, and economically. Today, we will discuss the next subtopic, a new conservatism after 1815. Students, as you know, Napoleon was defeated in the famous Battle of Waterloo on 18th of June 1815. Where is Waterloo? It is in Belgium. It was a part of the United Kingdom of the Netherlands at that time. This battle marked the end of the Napoleonic Wars. Following the defeat of Napoleon in 1815, European governments were driven by a spirit of conservatism. Who were called conservatives? Let us recall our class 9 Russian Revolution chapter, where we read liberals, radicals, and conservatives. Earlier, in the 18th century, conservatives had been opposed to the idea of change. Conservatives believed that established traditional institutions of state and society, like the monarchy, the church, property, the family, should be preserved. However, most conservatives did not want to go back to the society of pre-revolutionary days. Rather, they believed that modernization that was initiated by Napoleon could in fact strengthen traditional institutions like the monarchy. It could make state power more effective and strong. A modern army, an efficient bureaucracy, a dynamic economy, the abolition of feudalism and serfdom could strengthen the autocratic monarchies of Europe. In 1815, representatives of the European powers, Britain, Russia, Prussia, and Austria, who had collectively defeated Napoleon, met at Vienna to draw up a settlement for Europe. This conference is called the Congress of Vienna in the history of Europe. The Congress was hosted by the Austrian Chancellor Duke Metternich. After the fall of Napoleon, Metternich became the central figure not only in the politics of Austria and Germany, but in the diplomacy of the whole of Europe. Napoleon had changed the map of Europe to a large extent. The delegates drew up the Treaty of Vienna of 1815 with the objective of undoing most of the changes that had come during the Napoleonic Wars. The Bourbon dynasty, which had been deposed during the French Revolution, was restored to power. Count de Provence, brother of Louis XVI, was enthroned in France. He was now called Louis XVIII. France lost the territories it had annexed under Napoleon. A series of states were set up on the boundaries of France to prevent French expansion in future. Thus, the kingdoms of the Netherlands, which included Belgium, was set up in the north, and Genoa was added to Piedmont in the south. Austria was given control of Lombardy and Venetia, the provinces of northern Italy. In the east, Russia was given a part of Poland, while Prussia was given a portion of Saxony. But the German Confederation of 39 states that had been created by Napoleon was left untouched. The main intention was to restore the monarchies that had been overthrown by Napoleon and create a new conservative order in Europe. The Congress ignored the principles and feelings of nationality when they annexed Belgium to Holland, Lombardy and Venetia to Austria. In the same way, Germany and Italy were divided into different small states, mostly under the control of Austria. They rearranged Europe according to their desires, disposing it as if it were their own personal property. The Congress also ignored the feelings of the revolution. The feelings of liberty, equality, and fraternity were ignored. Rather, the diplomats at the Vienna Congress had promised to crush these revolutionary feelings. The two things against which the representatives set themselves were nationalism and democracy, which they considered to be the root of all political evil. These they tried to suppress without realizing how ingrained they were on the minds of the people. So we can say that the Treaty of Vienna was a setback to the process of nationalism. From 1815 to 1830, a conscious program by conservatives was put in place to contain revolution and revolutionary forces by restoring old orders, particularly previous ruling aristocracies. Britain, Prussia, Russia, and Austria renewed their commitment to prevent any restoration of Napoleon's power and agreed to meet regularly in conferences to discuss their common interests. The Congress of Vienna was only the beginning of conservative reaction bent on containing the liberal and nationalist forces unleashed by the French Revolution. Let us see the features of the conservative regimes. Conservative regimes set up in 1815 were autocratic. They did not tolerate criticism and dissent and sought to curb activities that questioned the legitimacy of autocratic governments. Most of them imposed censorship laws to control what was said in newspapers, books, plays and songs, and reflected the ideals of liberty and freedom associated with the French Revolution. The memory of French Revolution nonetheless continued to inspire liberals. One of the major issues taken up by the liberal nationalists who criticized the conservative order was freedom of press. During the following years, 1815, the fear of repression drove many liberal nationalists underground. Secret societies sprang up in many European states to train revolutionaries and spread their ideas. To be revolutionary at this time meant a commitment to oppose monarchical forms that had been established after the Vienna Congress and to fight for liberty and freedom. Most of these revolutionaries also saw the creation of nation-states as a necessary part of this struggle for freedom. One such individual was the Italian revolutionary Giuseppe Mazzini. Born in Genoa in 1807, he became a member of the secret society of the Carbonari. The Carbonari in Italian, it means charcoal makers. The Carbonari was an informal network of secret revolutionary societies, active in Italy from about 1800 to 1831. The Carbonari operated largely in secret. As a young man of 24, he was sent into exile in 1831 for attempting a revolution in Liguria. He subsequently founded two more underground societies, first Young Italy in Marseille and then Young Europe in Bonn, whose members were like-minded young men from Poland, France, Italy, and the German states. Mazzini believed that God had intended nations to be the natural units of mankind. So, Italy could not continue to be a patchwork of small states and kingdoms. It had to be forged into a single unified republic within a wider alliance of nations. This unification alone could be the basis of Italian liberty. Following his model, secret societies were set up in Germany, France, Switzerland, and Poland. Mazzini's relentless opposition to monarchy and his vision of democratic republics frightened the conservatives. Metternich described him as the most dangerous enemy of our social order. With this, I finish my topic of the day. Students, now you should be able to answer these questions. What do you understand by the term conservatism? Conservatism is a political philosophy that stressed the importance of tradition, established institutions and customs, and preferred gradual development to quick change. Question number 2. Who hosted the Vienna Congress in 1815? Austrian Chancellor Duke Metternich. 3. What was the main objective of the Treaty of Vienna of 1815? The main objective was to restore the monarchies that had been overthrown by Napoleon and create a new conservative order in Europe. Explain the main features of the Treaty of Vienna. This question is very important for your examination. You must prepare it. Important among them, the Bourbon dynasty, which had been deposed during the French Revolution, was restored to power. France lost the territories it had annexed under Napoleon. A series of states were set up on the boundaries of France to prevent French expansion in future. Austria was given control of northern Italy. In the east, Russia was given part of Poland, while Prussia was given a part of Saxony. 5. Enumerate the features of conservative regimes set up in Europe in 1815. Conservative regimes were autocratic. They did not tolerate activities that questioned the legitimacy of the autocratic governments. Most of them imposed censorship laws to control what was said in newspapers and reflected the ideas of liberty and freedom. You can take the help of slides used during explanation. 6. Why did the most conservative regimes impose censorship laws to control printed materials associated with the French Revolution in 1815? This is a port question, CBSE 2019, 1 mark question, because they reflected the idea of liberty and freedom. 7. What were the main aim of revolutionaries of Europe? To oppose the monarchical order established after the Vienna Congress and struggle for liberty and freedom. 8. What were Mazzini's views about Italy? Mazzini believed that God had intended nations to be the natural units of mankind, so Italy could not be a patchwork of small states and kingdoms. It had to be forged into a single unified republic within a wider alliance of nations. 9. How was Mazzini described by Metternich? Metternich described Mazzini as the most dangerous enemy of the social order, that means his conservative social order. With this, we finish Unit 2, The Making of Nationalism in Europe. This helped us to understand the political features of mid-18th century Europe. We understood the meaning of liberalism and conservatism as opposing views. Now, we will see the next unit, The Age of Revolutions, in the next class. For any queries, you can use the comment section. And please don't forget to subscribe. Keep reading. Thank you.